Welcome, welcome, Buzzheads. Buzz Conference number 9. It's Matt and Tattoo from 94.7 The Morning Buzz with Evanescence. Let's hear it for Evanescence, guys. Come on.
Evanescence Day at the Bricktown Event Center in downtown Bricktown.
Yeah, there's a few tickets left, so if you do so desire, and I would highly suggest that you do, drop by the box office and grab some before the show tonight with Revis and Depswa and Die Trying. Got a bunch of buzzheads here, five in to be specific, and they're going to step up and ask you guys just any question out of the book, so get ready.
Sounds good.
Here we go.
Okay, first off, we've got... No. Jory, yeah, we're
going to
go backwards.
Hi.
Hey, what's up? What's your name?
I'm Jory.
Hi.
I had to write my question down because I thought I'd forget it. The Daredevil soundtrack featured hot bands like Fuel and Saliva. I want to know, how does it feel to know that Bring Me to Life was definitely the biggest hit of that album?
Ben, would you like to answer this question? It feels really good. I mean, how do you think? It feels great. You can't ever expect what's going to happen. It could go badly. It could go well, you know. We felt very lucky just to be on the soundtrack with all of those artists, whether the song had been successful or not. It's definitely a great feeling.
Okay, Buzz Conference number 9 with Evanescence here on 94.7 The Buzz with Matt and Tattoo.
Wow, it's smoky in here. We're in the Bricktown Event Center. And the band is actually sitting up on the stage. It's very cool.
Yeah, if you've ever been to the Bricktown Event Center, you kind of know, ooh, that's feedback. If you've ever been inside here, you know there's a big high-rise stage, and we got the band sitting up on stage. Why don't you guys go through and introduce yourself so the buzz kids can hear you.
Okay. I'm Amy. I sing.
I'm Ben, and I stand here.
I'm John. I'm just here for the looks.
I'm Rocky. I play drums.
I'm Will. I'm actually his drum tech.
All right, cool. Will. Next buzz head up for Buzz Conference 9, Daniel. Daniel, where are you at? Step up here, Daniel. And Evanescence.
I own that shirt.
Yeah, Ben wears that shirt on stage all the time.
My question was more pertaining to Rocky, of like how you made the transition from the guitarist from Living Sacrifice to a drummer in a softer band, also heavy metal.
Like it just kind of happened. Yeah, it just kind of happened. It was like 97, 98. I did a track with Ben and Amy a long time ago, and just been friends ever since then. And they needed a guy to come up, play drums, and that was me. It just happens.
Full of pep, isn't he?
Seven The Buzz at Bricktown Event Center with Evanescence sitting on the stage. It's Evanescence Day in Oklahoma City.
Hi, I'm just curious about the name of your band, Evanescence. Is that close to effervescence, or what's the difference?
What's the difference? Well, evanescence means to dissipate like vapor. It's sort of, I don't know, an image. I think it's a really cool image. It like kind of paints a picture in your head. That's why we chose it. I think it's kind of mysterious and unusual and beautiful. I think effervescence is usually used in Alka-Seltzer commercials. So I think that's the difference.
A nice bubbly tree.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah?
Thanks, Russell. It's Buzz Conference 9, Matt and Tattoo, The Morning Buzz, 94.7 The Buzz, inside the Bricktown Event Center. Evanescence up on stage, participating in this great Buzz Conference. Number 9, Ricky is up next. Where are you at, Ricky? Slide on up here. And Ricky's studying to be a lawyer, so watch out.
Uh-oh.
Okay, no legalese today. My question's kind of a two-parter. The first part would be, your music seems to be somewhat dark, but very emotional, and yet it's uplifting and determined at the same time. I was wondering where a band from Little Rock, Arkansas finds like the creative inspiration to write that type of music, and is it being from Little Rock that has made you the type of band that you are?
We moved.
I think that it doesn't matter where you are, you can be creative, and you can definitely be an artist and just work with what you have. Sometimes being locked up and being isolated is the best place for art to be bred. This is great. They all come bearing gifts.
Chelsea's next.
I want to give them to you.
You ready, Chelsea?
Short. Hi. Hi. I want to know how you guys feel about being an inspiration to teenagers like me.
Aw. I'm almost a teenager. I'm only 21. I don't know. That's definitely an awesome thing. I think that if you can ever be in a position to be any kind of an example or just, I don't know, do your best to be a nice person, if that influences people, that's wonderful. Especially artistically inspiring, that would be a great compliment if we were that.
I just talked my parents into letting me pick my eyebrow. You have yours.
Uh-oh. Sorry, Mom and Dad, not my fault. My parents were mad at me, too.
Okay, did we get everybody?
I didn't ask permission.
Everybody
I just got in trouble.
Everybody got a question, right?
Yeah, this is a little bit different on Buzz Conference number 9 because we're sitting on the stage. We're actually in the Bricktown Event Center. We got the lights going, and the band has got a wireless, and they're sitting across from us, and it's just different. There's some smoke and mirrors. And Jimmy Beretta standing in the back. 94.7 The Morning Buzz. Do you have a question that you would like to ask Evanescence face-to-face at Buzz Conference number 9, Matt?
No.
You don't?
No, where do you live now? I mean, you said you guys moved. Where'd you move to?
Well, we're moving every day because we live on the tour bus.
So your address is the Prevost?
It's a constant year-and-a-half long move.
Is it really?
I don't know where we're going to end up, really.
What make and model is the tour bus? What year is it? The Buzzheads want to know.
2001 Prevo. It is.
Does this Prevo? Does this money come out of your futures for?
What is it? What is it now?
I mean, how do they? How
Everything
do they do that?
Comes out of
you
our
just
future.
Go out, do you buy the bus?
No. You lease it with the driver. It comes with the driver.
What kind of engine does it have in it? Is it like running a Allison or a?
It's like a
It's
like a lawnmower with 10 wheels.
Is it quiet?
It's got PosiTrack.
Is it quiet?
It just does.
Yes. Okay. It's quiet because now we don't have to share the bus with all these guys. We actually have two. So it's nice and quiet at night.
Cool. That wraps
it
up.
We have the fun bus and the lame bus. So. Oh.
They have the fun bus, actually. Ours is the lame bus. It's very quiet.
Okay, so you really didn't come from Little Rock because I was telling all the Buzzheads that you came from Little Rock today, but it was really Albuquerque, right? Amarillo.
Yesterday we were in Amarillo, yes. Oh. Isn't that right? The day before yesterday, yeah.
So what does it take, about 5 hours going on the 40 to get here to Oklahoma City?
I don't know. I was sleeping.
I mean,
I sleep
like
when we drive.
It's your brothers here, you know.
I
we're
wake
Oklahoma
up over
City.
There.
We're right down the road.
I know.
Okay, so we're so thankful that you came out.
Oh, well,
spent
we're
some,
definitely
some
glad to be here.
Time with us and participated in Buzz Conference number 9. And
thank you.
Buzz. Thank you, guys.
Congratulations on the success.
Thank you very much.
Let's hear it for Evanescence. Come on.
Yay!
Yay!
Me!